गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे अगेन वी आर हेयर विद द पोएम ऑन किलिंग अ ट्री बाय जय पटेल एंड अर्लियर वी डिड टू स्टैंजास. टुडे विल डू नेक्स्ट टू स्टैंजास एंड वी शैल आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द स्टैंजास एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एंड अदर थिंग्स वी शैल डिस्कस इन लाइव क्लास. एंड आई वुड लाइक यू टू रीड द पोएम, रिवाइज द पोएम, डू द डिफिकल्ट वोकैबुलरी. स्टिल देल बी एनी प्रॉब्लम यू कैन आस्क मी. नाउ अगेन वी आर डूइंग स्टैंजा नंबर 3 and 4. नाउ हेयर इन स्टैंजा नंबर 3 द पोएट इज टेलिंग अस द रूट आर द सोर्स ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ फॉर द ट्री. So, no, the root is to be pulled out of the anchoring earth. It is to be wrapped tight and pulled out, snapped out. The poet is saying, if you want to kill a tree, it has to be pulled out along with the roots from under the earth. Agar aap iski jad ko bahar nikalenge, only then it will be killed. Fixed firmly anchoring earth because its roots are firmly attached with this earth because it is deep under the earth. So you can pulled out, snapped out or it entirely out from the earth cave. And the strength of the tree exposed, when the root is out, the its strength is exposed, the tree is exposed and the source white and wet, the most sensitive hidden for years inside the earth. So root is the strength of the tree that is exposed and fresh root means it is white and wet. जब भी आप जड़ बाहर निकालते हो तो गीली भी होती है, सफ़ेद भी होती है, protected by the earth for years. So the poet wants to tell us the actual process that can kill a tree as axing or chopping cannot end the life of a tree. It is the root deep under the surface of the earth that needs to be attacked. The root is held tightly and supported by the nourishing earth and is not easy to destroy. The strength of the tree is its root. If you want to kill it, you have to pull out the root and then the root is out. हम यही कहते हैं ना कि अगर जड़ को हवा लग जाती है तो फिर पेड़ दोबारा नहीं लगाया जाता, पौधा दोबारा नहीं लगाया जाता. So when you want to pull it out, you have to tie it firmly with ropes. रस्सियों से बांधते हैं पेड़ को, फिर खींचते हैं, तब ये जड़ से उखड़ता है. Then apply great force to completely uproot it. So, because the tree's, strength lies in its root. So that is what is a suggestion, an ironical suggestion we can say by the poet. If you want to kill a tree, kill it by with the help of a root. Here we have stanza number 4. Tree exposed along with the roots. Then the matter of scorching and choking in the sun and air, browning, hardening, twisting, withering, and then it is done. That means when tree is exposed along with the roots, it is attacked by harsh scorching heat of the sun and the air. And then the poet says that uprooted tree ultimately dies. The scorching heat of the sun and exposure to the air, it smothers the root of the tree. However, it does not die at once. It grows, first of all, its color is changed. The root turns from white to brown. Then it becomes dry. Then it becomes hard. It is no more wet because its moisture is soaked by the sunshine. And it loses its shape also. It seems brown, soft, white, wood, and it is finally weak and dull, and it dies, then it is done. So the hardened root gets twisted and eventually it withers away completely, and in this way the tree dies ultimately. So the tree is finally killed when it is uprooted, withers away completely, and it is the because the root is the source of the survival of the tree. When the root has gone, the tree cannot survive. So this poem is ironical poem which actually telling us that we should not cut the tree, and if we are cutting its branches or its log, then it doesn't die. It dies only when it is completely uprooted. And it takes several years to take the form of a tree, and we just with the help of an axe or a knife cut it down. That is really wrong. We should save the environment and we should not kill the trees. Now you will read, revise the poem. Still, if there will be any problem, we shall discuss the question answers and other problems which you will bring there in the live class. That's all for this poem. Thank you and have a nice day.